Hey guys, we're back.
Hello.
We're gonna have a match between Gemini and Schofleck, a PVT, and we're gonna get started pretty soon. Just a few ready or not stuff. Both players seem to be ready, so we'll be getting into the game. First map is GSL Whirlwind. So, what do you expect from the map?
Yeah, the loading screen has started. The map is gonna be Whirlwind, yeah?
Yeah, it's a big map.
Yeah, it's a huge map. I think it doesn't favor any of the races. It favors Zerg race the most. But, I don't know, we'll see. Macro games are pretty often and common on this map.
Yep.
Because you can actually cheese because of the four spawn positioning and whatnot.
Okay,
so yeah, you do the honors.
Yep, the match is live, and lower right side of the map we have Serbian Terran Gemini, and on the left side, left bottom side of the map, we have Slovenian Protoss Schofleck.
Yep. Ooh, yay!
Yes, I'm cheering, guys. Otherwise, I think Gemini is a favorite in this matchup between those two players. But we'll see. Both players are active, playing a lot, so you never know.
Mm-hmm. This is Group B, if
yep.
I'm not wrong.
This
I'm not
is
mistaken.
Group B, yeah.
And Schofleck is most definitely the underdog of this group. Gemini is top masters, as far as I know, and we're gonna see what will be, yeah?
Yep, Gemini has to win this if he wants to stay in the game to advance, while Schofleck as well most likely has to win this and his game against Breach as well.
Yeah, Schofleck has a tough path in front of him if he wants to go into the second round. Gemini is asking if it's cross only. I can assure that it's not.
Yeah, it's not, because it's such a big map. I think both all spawns
are possible. Yeah. I believe it's so as well.
It's a huge map, so
pretty
standard
opening from both of the players so far.
Yeah, of course we could have the cybernetic. Both players cut it wrong, or let's say they're gonna.
It seems Gemini is going for CC after the Rex.
Yep, most likely Antique, definitely the best idea. And I think Schofleck will or should go for the same thing. I guess it's a big map, so it favors macro play. Also with the ramp here.
Mm-hmm. Since he's taking the second guess so fast, I don't know, but yeah, that would be the best choice for Schofleck to do.
Both players are in the dark, scouting wrong locations. And they'll see that it's not cross only, but it's cross everything. So, still no.
They both know where they are now.
Yeah, that's true.
Since they both scouted two wrong locations,
they just don't know what's happening.
Gemini's bunker is already complete.
Schofleck skipped the first Zealot. I think that's not such a bad idea on such a big map. But still, he still doesn't have an expand.
Yeah, it's a wise decision since Stalker is way more mobile than Zealot. And we see that just there, that because of that Stalker, Gemini won't get any scout information about the Schofleck's composition, and it can be a four-gate. We don't know yet.
Exactly. And
even we don't know, so yeah.
Yeah, Gemini is adding junior two more racks now, and up to four. I think that's gonna be enough, but he's not gonna boosting anything, so
he's not taking any guess, so I think this is gonna be quite heavy bio marine only, maybe pressure from Gemini.
Oh yeah, that's true, and he will lose the Spoker, and this might be quite okay. Two sentries are enough. But maybe a 4 gate, 4 prison?
Oh, proxy robo.
Yep, 4 gate, or 3 gate.
3 gate, 4 prison it seems, yeah. Those 2 gates are little slow, I mean late.
Yeah.
The warp gate research will finish much faster than the gates will. But never mind, the warp prism is gonna be... I mean, Shkof is gonna wait for warp prism anyway, so...
Okay, so Gemini is going for a little push, I guess.
Yeah. Quite a bad timing from, to be honest.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, he's making an immortal.
Hmm, that's weird.
Yeah, this will delay everything for Shkoflex attack, while he will have to force field the ramp, otherwise he might lose a lot or maybe even everything.
He should force field the other ramp, I mean the first one, I guess.
Yeah, he does, he has to.
Well, this was pretty, these were pretty good force fields.
Yeah, they were, but he has to force field the...
Sentry micro wasn't that good.
Upper ramp as well.
Mm, he needs to warp in the force field as soon as possible.
But he has no...
He has no answer for this, I guess.
Yep. I don't know how he will... He's going for a base trade, I guess.
Yeah, base trade scenarios here. Right in front of us, Gemini responding by putting down the two additional bunkers in front of the ramp. Shkoflex ignoring it, but he lost the main... count of the probes in their main base. I mean, he didn't lost them yet, but they're going down like butter.
Well, but this doesn't... The Shkoflex has to make a lot of damage because he doesn't have an expand. I guess he has to win the game. But those two immortals out of nowhere...
Yeah, the SCV pull from Gemini now. And Gemini is quite in an awkward position.
Look that...
Bad for Shkoflex, yeah. Shkoflex pulled some amazing tactics there, after all, yeah.
Another immortal joining, no other units though, but...
I mean, I'm impressed, to be honest.
Yeah, GG. GG from Gemini. So Shkoflex takes the map.
Well, yeah, for 1 second I thought that Shkoflex lost all the probes because he was mineral walking them and stacking him. It seemed like it was just one, but good defense with probes.
Yeah.
And pretty nice push on the other side. Gemini didn't expect, as you said, two immortals from nowhere, and it's GG. Nice game from Shkoflex, really nice.
Yep. So it's 1-0. Out of the blue, I guess. Nobody really expected the win for Shkoflex.
Yep. And we're on in the game 2. We're actually on the loading screen. It's gonna be Ohana. This is cross only map.
Yes, this is cross only map. Just a second. And here we are, guys. Can you introduce the players?
Sure. In the upper left corner, we have a purple Terran from Serbia. It's Gemini.
Oh yeah, hooray!
And in the lower right corner, we have the underdog of this group, currently leading 1-0. It is Shkoflex.
Hooray!
The red Protoss, I forgot to mention.
Yep, the red Protoss indeed, and he pulled something quite amazing. I think this is the first underdog victory of the tournament, except for, let's say, Eonus winning against Shkoflex. I mean, sorry,
Starbuck,
yeah. A map, again, I guess. But
that's true.
Hidden Robo, Proxy Robo, we thought it would be an immortal, I mean, a warp gate, but it was not. And he somehow managed to catch Gemini off guard and hit the, well, great timing, I guess.
Yeah, the timing was pretty great.
Gemini off guard.
Or actually, the timing of Gemini's move
know,
out
yeah.
with Marines was awful.
Yeah, but he didn't know.
We were expecting a warp prism 4 gate, yeah, and that's actually an answer why it was only 3 gate. We were wondering why there's not a 4 gate going down from Skoflex side, and yeah, it was an immortal push, immortal proxy, and not warp prism, so.
Yeah, I mean,
pretty amazing tactic from Skoflex.
Exactly.
I mean, it worked amazing on that map in that case.
It worked out.
Pretty awesome. There were two immortals in Gemini's main base out of the blue, so he was just like, what the fuck, I guess.
Well, Skoflex went for one base play, some kind of all in, I guess, because with Proxy Robo, you don't really count on doing a lot and maybe expanding yourself, but winning out of the blue, I guess.
Yeah, most definitely. He was like,
okay, so
coin flipping actually, and
yeah,
worked.
The probe escaped, but it saw the CC in the making, so he at least knows that. We'll see what Skoflex goes for this time.
Yeah, Skoflex actually knows everything what he needs to know.
Yep. I guess he might just still go.
I think he should do that. I think he should put the expand on, as you said, in the first match.
Yeah. Or will he try to play some unusual tactics again? We'll see what happens.
Or maybe try the same tactic, yeah, why not, actually? If it worked for the first time, why wouldn't it for the second?
Yeah.
I mean, two immortals can melt even the bunker, and it can, it pretty much be GG.
And Gemini is now checking around.
Yeah, Gemini is already checking for proxies.
I think it's a wise decision.
Skoflex will put an expand on it.
Check this place as well, I mean left side of the downside of the base. But yeah, I think Skoflex is waiting to put the expand. And
it goes down now.
He waited.
He killed the probe first, I mean the SUV.
Exactly, Gemini is looking to... Well, he was about to check the place, but he did not. Anyhow, there's nothing there, so... Skoflex isn't adding, he should be adding a few gates now, maybe a robo.
Yeah, Skoflex should tech up as soon as possible.
Yeah, he's going because the classic 3-gate, 2-gate after, I mean 3-gate after expansion. Plus 2-gates after expansion. Again checking around, being careful this time.
I think we're gonna see robo afterwards. Stacking the money and the gas for it.
Yep. It should go down right about now. Gemini is seeing
Gemini
the
close, yeah.
Yep. We could use some help here. And this stalker should get away, yep.
Yeah, this stalker finds the path to survivability.
Gemini did see the standard brigade, but he did not see the robo, which just came down. And Gemini is again going for a push. And he has quite an army supply lead.
Yeah, the same kind of push as we saw last game.
Yep.
Like 15 marines or so. It's actually 13.
Yeah, it's 17 and 4 in the making as well. And Skoflex should see it already. He will lose the probe, but still not warping any units. He does have two sentries to force field, and he just
force fields.
Good force
fields. Pretty nice.
Nice trapping though, but he shouldn't lose the sentry. He does have
sentry
a lot.
Goes
of
down.
He should kite and he
nice stutter
well.
Step.
Yeah.
There's two stock, three stalkers versus four marines, and that
nice
stalker have it.
Yeah. Gemini's push was successfully stopped.
Yeah, nice hold by Skoflex, losing only two sentries and a stalker, if I'm not mistaken. And oh, and there was one probe blocking the path. He instantly puts robo bay down. He's playing it also carefully, placing building structures and everything down after Gemini leaves the base. So Gemini is in dark as far, I mean, as long as he can be.
Yeah. I mean, he could scan, but I guess he likes the income more.
Yeah, I mean, he playing pretty greedy, yeah.
Okay, he did lose a stalker there needlessly. Maybe he picked up
a marine?
Yeah, marine or two, but I don't think so. Maybe a marine. He will be able to hold this push again, I guess, with the force fields, but I doubt Gemini will go for it.
Yeah, Colossi is already in production, so two force fields wait for Colossi, and I think Schkoflik is good again. Yeah, as you said, Gemini isn't going for it. He's waiting at the southern vision, yeah, only checking for the third with the lonely marine.
Maybe he'll wait for steam.
Yeah, maybe he's waiting for steam timing and one attack.
But Colossus will be done shield. And yeah, Schkoflik's playing pretty well.
Yeah, Schkoflik's playing it carefully.
Okay, but Gemini seems like that he had enough heat supply blocked, and that's not something you would like in this type of situation.
No, of course not. Any supply block puts you in slight disadvantage, so
exactly, so I guess that's why he went back, because he had all the units queued up and no supply.
Mm-hmm.
He will be taking a third.
He will be taking a third for sure. I don't know why Schkoflik isn't taking glance. Oh, now he is, just when I say it, because it's like 1.5 Colossus almost done and Lance haven't even started.
Yeah,
but now it did.
Bit late.
Now it did, but it should have been almost completed by now. That was my point.
Yep, and he, I guess, is moving up.
Yeah, he's moving up with two Colossi pressure, but no forward pylon. That's not such a good idea right now.
Exactly. I think he wanted to expand, maybe just clear the vision. We'll see what he goes for. He will clean this marine out. And like you said, we're missing a forward pylon from Schkoflik.
Mm-hmm.
But
Gemini
is having a nice army supply and worker supply lead at the moment, at least.
Mm-hmm.
But both players are having a pretty decent control of the map. Well, not that great from Schkoflik, but
Schkoflik's little supply blocked.
That's
gonna hurt him a little.
And we might have a engagement at the middle.
Oh, this won't be good for Schkoflik, I guess.
Yeah,
or maybe
of
it will. Nice.
Yeah,
snagging those little units for nothing.
And
it's always worth it.
Gemini is trying. He's going to see for the base, and there will be none.
Oh,
nice engagement from Gemini. I have to say, splitting the Schkoflik's force and just ripping through two Colossi. I think that was huge from Gemini.
Yep, that was huge mistake, or actually a blunder from.
Yeah. Well,
from Schkoflik.
Another mule, but another Colossus joins the fight and.
Yeah, Schkoflik will survive for now, but
yeah, that's true. Gemini has third base and
suddenly he's 1,000 resources lost behind, and that's gonna hurt
yeah,
him
it was
for
a
sure.
Very great, very good engagement from Gemini. I guess, I mean, I think so, because
actually
his force.
Actually, it was a pretty stupid mistake from Schkoflik, because he was following the.
Exactly.
One marauder and two marines with all of his army, and that's and why? Because he was protecting which third not even existed, so
yeah, it was
I
a
don't
mistake
know.
From Schkoflik, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
A blunder from Schkoflik, otherwise Gemini played it.
Oh,
well,
and
I
here's
guess.
The SUV train,
yeah.
Gemini is taking it serious,
yeah.
But
I don't know why. He's up.
Well, yeah, he's in front of him.
I mean, I don't know.
And he can't break this, I guess.
It'll be hard to break, yeah. He has three bases, I don't know why he's. Well, he has an army supply lead, I guess. But it's getting smaller and smaller by every second he waits with those SUVs. Well, they could be mining, I guess.
15 SUVs healing in front of Schkoflik's base, and that's good for Schkoflik.
Yeah, that's great, I mean.
One more Colossus joins the battle.
Yeah, three Colossus, that's
a lot. He can't engage in this choke point, he can't. If he engages, he loses.
Oh, maybe he could have let a lot more units down. Up, I mean. He
I
could
think
have engaged more. From
Gemini realized now.
Yeah, that he can't break that.
Schkoflik has way too much.
Tech 1 versus 1-1 for Gemini, he is in a lead. That's the no, not. I mean, that's pretty obvious, but he has a. He doesn't have a lot of gas. That's for one.
Schoflek has
worker supply lead.
Worked 6 zealots on the front pylon and the 4th of the Gemini.
Yep, and he's going to harass a nice small multi-pron attack from Schoflek, I would say.
Yeah,
to keep
good.
Him, his opponent busy. Oh, and now both
maybe catch him off guard, which
yeah.
He did now. 5 units for free.
Now more Vikings join the fight, but...
with force fields.
Another manner move.
Gemini has too much.
Gemini just had too much. In the end, I think the battle where Schoflek lost two Colossi for nothing was decisive.
Yep, it sure was.
But he needlessly lose the Colossi, I don't know why he's moving it away.
Yep, the Colossi goes down and it's GG from Schoflek. Score is tied, 1-1.
Score is tied and Gemini ties the match series to 1-1.
Mm-hmm. And we're going to the decisive map.
Yep, that's
true. Which is gonna be?
I don't know, and Schoflek will be picking the map.
Good, good. We'll hop right into it, guys.
Okay, Schoflek is looking for a map list, map pool. So he's going to pick a map that I know he likes.
Yeah. It's his final chance.
Yep. Even this game that he lost, I think Schoflek showed a good play. Well, bearing that with exception of that mistake that cost him the game, in my opinion. He was quite good, I mean.
Yeah, exactly. Except for that engagement from Schoflek, he was playing pretty damn good, and if he wouldn't made that mistake, I think he would won. Well, actually, if he wouldn't made that mistake and take an expansion, take the third, which he wasn't even protected, I mean.
It would depend on the other battles then, but they were quite even, and I have to say that Schoflek is showing some good game, while Gemini is as well. Showing that he's when he's really
he's really good, one of the top Serbian players.
Yeah, but, and he was like when he was paying attention, he scouted for everything, and you know what I mean. He
mm-hmm.
had things under control, and
yep.
A minor mistake from Schoflek for losing those two Colossus, which ended up being the decisive thing.
Yeah, that totally broke up the match for Schoflek.
So, we are in the game.
Yep, it's game 3, guys.
Game 3, indeed, and on the lower light, left side of the map, we have a green Protoss from Slovenia, Schoflek. And on the top right side of the map, we have Serbian Terran, red Terran, Gemini. Cheers for both players. Both are showing exciting games, to be exact. I didn't expect those exciting matches like this. I mean, we saw first proxy succeed, and we saw Gemini getting Schoflek to fall on some, let's say, newbie tricks. So players are square. Both use their advantage one time, you know what I mean, like Schoflek being underdog, doing something
something special
yeah, and Gemini just using some tricks. And yeah, this is it, the third decisive match that no one I guess expected to happen.
Yeah, you're right. I mean, Schoflek was quite inactive for a long time, I guess. He even fell to Diamond League in his back up to Masters now, I mean. And yeah, his play is resilient, I mean, perfect, except for that blunder, and if it weren't for that blunder, I wonder if we would be here. I mean, he could take the map, the second map as well, and took the series 2-0, and...
Yeah, that would be surprising.
But that didn't happen, so, yeah. We're gonna see what his plans are for this map. Gemini in lobby already trolled him a little that it's gonna to be Trigate Robo Blink map tactic from Skovlek, and yeah, we'll see what will be.
Yeah, I mean, he might be right, this is a great Blink map.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of blinking opportunities up down the high ground.
Yeah, the scouting probe is getting harassed by the Lonely Marine.
And Gemini
the same tactic, yeah, as the first two maps from Gemini. 1rex fast expand.
Yep, and Skovlek will see that.
Skovlek saw that for sure. Gemini is again scouting for the Twilight or the Roba.
I guess Gemini is really expecting Blink. Especially after seeing the a little, maybe a little bit faster gas, but not really that much. We'll see what it comes down to. Gemini is adding another 2 racks, like the usual Terran stuff after 1 rack expand.
Skovlek again skipped the Zealot.
Yep.
Opening with the Stalker first.
Which is a great thing, I mean, it's no problem in this situation, but...
And he's going for gateway, 1 gate expand. It seems. Yeah, he's going for 1 gate expand.
Yep, and... Gemini will nicely scout this, I guess Skovlek's stalker is out of position.
There's no chrono boost wasted for Skovlek, so that's pretty cheesy, I guess. Weird,
yeah.
At least.
Maybe a mistake.
Maybe a mistake.
I mean, if not anything else... Okay, now Skovlek playing some mind tricks with wasting a force field. Just for scouting purposes. And maybe he will waste... He will make Gemini waste energy for scanning. We'll see. Skovlek also adding 2 gates like usual after expanding. We'll see if he'll go for Robo or...
For our Twilight, yeah, we'll see. But what's interesting enough is that Gemini still didn't take any gas, nor in main, nor in expansion.
Yeah.
Well, now he did, yeah. But he was again producing strictly Marines with no add-ons from 4 barracks, and the
push.
The push is happening again. It's the same as in the first and the second game. In the first, it counted him of some decent hold, if not the loss. And in the second, it was kind of worth it. And now we'll see what will be here in this push. If he kills this Nexus, that's victory for him. I mean,
yeah,
it's gonna
be
huge.
It's gonna kill that Nexus.
But Skovlek
should go as soon as possible. I mean, he should go all nice bad positioning from the moment. He sniped this down.
Yeah, he killed both sentries, Zealot, 1 stalker. As I said, this push can be devastating. It's 4 barracks, you know, that's a lot. Constantly making Marines. By four streaming into the main group, by 4 reinforcements, that is. And there's 5 stalkers against 13 Marines, and that's not much stalkers can do.
Yep. He doesn't really look good for Skovlek. He's also supply block.
And he's also supply block.
Yeah,
he even can't warp in sentry. If
exactly.
Gemini would know that, he would walk straight up the ramp and kill him right here, right now. And this is bad for Skovlek, really bad. He's still not making any pylons. He has full chrono boost. He could make like 2 warpings in a row in no time and clean this force up. But
yeah, he's making 3 pylons now, but I think this is too late.
Yeah. Well, Gemini will most definitely won't walk up the ramp now because he expects one sentry at least on top of it. But
yeah, and those trade-offs at the ramp weren't that good for Gemini.
No, they weren't at all because they were only hitting the stalkers and losing their shields, no health.
Maybe he can snipe that.
No, he won't. Safely turn around and go, but Schkoflek is gonna slowly but surely demolish this whole ass. No, he will lose a stalker. Maybe two.
Yep.
Yeah, he lost two. I don't know why Schkoflek didn't stay like this and fight when he had seven. He lost three stalkers for nothing. It could be only.
A little bit of miss micro, and this is a bunker line that just cannot be broken by Schkoflek like at the moment.
Nope.
He's starting his expand with a
huge delay.
Huge delay.
There's a scan revealing everything that Schkoflek like is only on 3 gate, nothing else.
Okay, so we have an engagement, but those stalkers are just going to die. GG from Schkoflek. Like.
GG.
GG. So Gemini takes the series 2-1. It was more exciting than we thought. Schkoflek showed good match, especially the first map. I mean, good. He is some special tactics, and he caught Gemini out of position and managed to win the first map. The second map, like we said, was also quite close, and the third Gemini more or less showed how it's played. I mean,
what he's made of.
Exactly. Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, pretty convincing win from Gemini, except that unfortunate move out in the first map when he actually couldn't know for that proxy robo, and it cost him a game. But since it's best of three, he came back and took home the victory.
Yep, that's correct. And this is it for tonight. Gemini winning Schkoflek 2-1. And let me just revise what happened today earlier. We had two matches. First one was Stunter versus Vladoika, exciting match, which was won by Stunter. By 2-2 against 1. So you should watch the replay. Well, a little spoiler alert, but anyhow. And the second game was Frost between Frost versus Forte, also. Quite interesting game, so check those out, check other replays, check our schedule for other days, and also if you like LoL or StarCraft 2, sign up for our massacre event,
which is happening on Sunday the 20th of January.
Yep. I'm Tretch, and with me was
hi, I'm Attacker. Thanks for joining us, guys.
Yep, and we're going off, so good night.
Good night.